I promise you, if you miss it today, if you bleed twice, you may miss it. Amen. I want to first of all give honor to God for another day's journey. Thank God for this worship ministry. I told them this morning, as they were coming in, I said, you all are going to have to be the sermon today. Amen. And I'm just telling you up front that today will not be long. Amen. But I've been there long enough that I don't have to justify what I can do. But I will tell you what I'm not going to do. And today I'm not going to be long. Amen. Today I want to just leave you with this thought taken from the Gospel according to John. I want to say, y'all don't have to play that way, but I promise you, if you play more than 5 minutes, I better get 2 minutes too long. Amen. Taken from the Gospel of John, Jesus is talking to his disciples and those who are following him, and he's laying out who he is and how different he is from what has come before. He's really making remarks to the Israeli or the governmental leaders, the temple leaders of Israel at the time. He is comparing himself to them and setting up the stage for what would happen to him on that Good Friday. Jesus says, I am, in verse 11, chapter 10, the good shepherd. The good shepherd lays down his life. I'm done. Y'all don't have to get up. Trust me. I'm telling you today. I promise you. I'm just not trying to tell you anything else that's not true. Amen. Y'all stood up to the men all the time. You see? I am the good shepherd. I lay down my life for my sheep. Here's the question that occupied my thoughts this week about this text. Have you ever been in a situation and you wondered if anybody really cared? Have you ever faced some challenges in life? And you knew who was with you before the challenge started. But when the fire got hot and the stuff hit the fan, you were surprised at the number of folk that could not and would not stand with you. Many preachers have been wounded. Yes, we have. By making the assumption that the folk that look at you on Sunday really care a lot about you. I'm in trouble now, Pastor. The reality of it is, on any given Sunday, you got folk who come to church for a lot of different reasons. And the real question that many of us have to deal with as life takes the turns it would take, does anybody really care about what I'm going through? If you haven't been there yet, just keep on living. I promise you that day will still come. When you are in the midst of something that you did not sign up for, when you are wrestling with a situation that is totally beyond your control to fix, when you can't call and make it stop, when you can't talk and make it stop, when you can't pay to make something stop, and you are really dealing with the hard issues of life, you will ask the question, does anyone really care? You need to know that that's how life is sometimes. Does anyone really care? And I want to tell you, to be perfectly honest and transparent, sometimes you will even ask that question of God's self. You will look up to heaven as you deal with one thing after the other, and you will wonder, does God really care? I'm going to get in trouble now. There's a story that is told about a young man whose mother, in her early 30s, was dying of cancer. This boy had been raised in Sunday school. He had gone to church Sunday after Sunday. It was he and his mom, and cancer showed up in her late 20s. And by her early 30s, cancer had taken its toll. This boy, because he was raised in Sunday school, kept telling everybody, doctors, caregivers, that I'm not worried because God don't take care of us. He kept telling it over and over again, I'm not worried, God don't take care of us. Only one day he hear the words that mama is gone, and his prayers had no answer. Have you ever been there when God didn't answer your prayer? When you wonder if God cared for you at all? Well, this text makes it clear. No matter how rough life may get, we can rest in this blessed assurance that Jesus cares about you. Whatever you're facing right now, it hadn't come as a surprise to God. And Jesus is not a stranger that stands off in the distance and doesn't really care. I want to tell you, Jesus cares about what you're going through. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. He said, I am somebody who will commit to those I care for. He said, I am not a hired hand. I won't leave you when danger comes, but I'll be right there. He says, I'm not like other folk. I won't run away when danger shows up. In fact, I'll lay down my life just for you. Jesus said, I'll lay it down and I'll pick it up again because I am a good shepherd. And if you belong to me, you know who I am. Jesus says, by using the good shepherd metaphor, I care completely for you. That boy asked the question, God, why? When mama left in her early 30s. But for the rest of the story, that boy didn't lose faith. That boy didn't give up on God. That boy just had to learn that sometimes life don't do what life don't do. But that same boy who lost his mama in his early 30s, was able to finish his grade school level, was able to go on to high school and go on and finish college, and eventually wound up going to medical school, become a doctor, to help somebody else. If you ask him today, he'll tell you, yes, Jesus cares. Even though I had to go through something, let my kids even know the Lord let me go through, he never gave up on me. And I want to say, anybody here that know like I know, the Lord has never given up on us. Because if friends turn their backs, if family can't return my phone call, if the support I used to have dwindles and fades away, if folk talk about me and say my time is up, the reality of it is I have a Savior who always has the last word. You have a Savior that always has the last word. My time is up. Thank you for your standing to me. We have a shepherd, a good shepherd, that will never leave us. Every hand.